Strake Law Library video is going to demonstrate how to use Microsoft Word to create category headings for your table of authorities. The categories you use must conform to the rules that you need to follow, whether those be court rules or instructions from your professor. Microsoft Word offers a default set of categories for tables of authorities. If you customize these categories, the changes are saved to your computer, not the document. That means you need to set the categories on whatever computer you will be using when you create your table of authorities. You can open the brief or even just a blank Word document to get started. The important thing is to be on the computer that you will be using to write your brief. I'm doing this on a PC, but it's going to look almost identical on a Mac. First, I click on References. And then, in the Table of Authorities section, I click the Mark Citation button. This brings up the Mark Citation dialog box. I click on Category. On a Mac, that would say Set Category. And this brings up the Edit Category dialog box. This shows the default categories that Word already has, followed by some numbers that allow you to set up 16 different categories. When you insert your table of authorities, the category headings will use the same wording shown here, and they will be organized in the same order they are listed in this drop-down box. Therefore, you will save time in the long run if you first ensure that the names and order of the categories are as you want them for your brief's table of authorities. If there are categories listed you do not think you will use, you can leave them. If you do not assign a particular category to your authorities when you are marking them, that category will simply not be listed in the table of authorities. If everything is as you want it, you can just click Cancel and you're done with this step. However, let's say I want to make a couple of changes. First, say that I want this category Rules to say Court Rules instead. I click on the category name, and then in the Replace With box, I can type the name that I actually want to use. In this case, I type Court Rules, and then I click Replace. Now this category reads Court Rules, not just Rules. Let's also say that I don't like the default order, and I want to move Other Authorities to the end. I click on Other Authorities, and then in the Replace With box, I can make it something that I know I'm not going to use. So in this case, I'm going to call it NA for Not Applicable. I click Replace, and that changes that category name. Then I can recreate the category of Other Authorities, listing it at the end of all of my categories. I click on 8. In the Replace With box, I type Other Authorities, and then I click Replace. Now, if I plan to use all 16 available categories, I would not be able to waste one by just calling it Not Applicable. But if I'm not using all the categories, this lets me get them in the desired order with less work. When I have everything the way I want it, I click on OK, and then I can close out of the Mark Citation dialog box. When I open up that box again and we look at the categories, we see they now are the way I changed them and not the way the Word defaults were. Setting the categories first means that once my brief is completely written and I am ready to mark the citations for my table of authorities, I will know that I have the desired category names in the right order. Thanks for watching.